Coach, could you just talk a little bit about Megan? This is kind of her day. The season she's had, particularly in the SEC for you guys.
She's been our glue piece. She's been the most consistent team member that we have. She's come in, she's done everything Holly and the staff have asked her to do. She's embraced, you know, we know everyone in the country knows she's our go-to player, but she's been trying to do other things, defend, making passes, you know, her average of assists have gone up tremendously this year. And I'm just extremely proud, you know, to have the opportunity to coach a young lady like Megan Simmons.
Are you concerned that you're asking or she's taking on too much or too much is being – I mean, she's really the last couple games. I mean, if she doesn't do what she does, you get beat. Would you guys like a little bit more?
We'd like a little more balance, but when she's hot, there's not many people in the country that can stop her. And we're trying to get the ball. A lot of times now people are starting to focus on our front court, our front line, and they're packing it in. So she's getting a lot more open looks because she's working the ball inside and out. So if they make the adjustments to, you know, come out on her, then we're going to continue to pound the ball inside.
Are there things you guys can do, even if they keep trying to pack it inside, to get your post players a few more looks?
And that's been the game plan from day one, because I think in my mind we have the best, you know, front line in the country, and we're trying to get Char going, get Izzy going early, Mercedes when she's coming in, and even, you know, lately Nia's been playing, but we're trying, that's our focus, to get the ball inside, work it inside, and then work it out.
Does Bashar need to be a little bit more aggressive, or is she just getting blanketed?
And I think a lot of people are definitely double-teaming her. They're sending two people to her on off because she's a great offensive rebounder. As soon as the shot's up, they're sending two people to block her out. And even when she's posting, they're just shoving her, trying to get off the block, being a lot more physical with her. So we're just trying to get her to stay composed and continue to go in and do what she does, post big, and trying to keep focusing our guards and getting the ball to her.
It's been a few years since y'all have beaten a top five team. What would it mean just going into the postseason to get a winner in the number 14? I know the SEC title's out of the picture, but kind of make a statement beating a top five team.
This is definitely a statement game. So now, you know, we want to end this regular season, you know, on a positive note, going into March Madness, as people say now, because once we go into, you know, it's March, you got one guaranteed game in the SEC tournament. And after that, you know, you have to pay 40 minutes to play again. So to beat a team, you know, a caliber team like, you know, South Carolina tomorrow would be huge for us. Not just for, you know, our confidence that we need a top team, but just going into March, you know, on a positive note.
Holly's talked about this a couple of times. Earlier in the year, you guys had a meeting, and she said Megan got up in front of everybody and said, look, I'm feeling a little pressure this year. It's my last year and stuff like that. You think it's helped her play to have done that, because it seems like that almost coincides with this hot stretch she's been on.
I think it relieved her a little bit just to be able to share with her team, and I don't think the team realized how much of a burden it was for her, because Megan never lets anything show. But when she got up and told them, hey, I'm trying, you know, I went through it as a senior myself, you know, this is your last hurrah, this is it. And once she let it out, I think her teammates started like realizing, oh my God, we didn't realize that you were carrying all this pressure. We'll help you as well. And with her teammates helping her, her confidence is back up, and now she's just playing free.
South Carolina has an extraordinary number of blocks. What is it they do defensively that just bothers teams so much?
Don is an incredible, you know, a phenomenal coach. They stress defense. And I just think that right now you have very athletic posts in Coates, Atlanta Coates, and even Welch, because Welch is very versatile. She's playing the inside and she's playing out. I just think that the guards, they're trying to contain, but once you get inside, they're, you know, they're protecting the paint, as you would say. Anything that's in the paint, they're, you know, they're guarding the paint. So I think Don does a very good job. The post, sometimes the hard three-quarters, sometimes they'll play directly behind. But their timing is impeccable. So we got to utilize a lot more shot fakes, a lot more ball fakes to, you know, to get their post up. So we just got to continue to attack, play our game. And if we get blocked once or twice, keep attacking.
Do they reflect – does this team, when you see them, do they reflect Dawn's personality? Are they like her?
Oh, definitely. I mean, they play, they're a scrappy team, blue-collar worker, play hard, you know, every possession. They're very, very unselfish team. Pass the ball, they know what they're looking for, very, very well coached. And they take on her personality. Dawn was a fiery type, you know, scrappy type point guard, right. And she demands a lot from them, and you can just see how that oozes out on each one of her.
They've been a good team the last couple of years. What's the difference you've seen them this particular season that's letting them go over the top?
They have a great front court, great inside. And in the past, their inside wasn't as strong. Their inside presence is there. And their guards, Tiffany Mitchell is shooting the ball extremely well. Khadija Sessions is coming to draw on a true point guard. And Asia Dozier, last year she was a freshman, she was real sort of streaky. Now she's more consistent. And I just think they have a balance. They have an outside game, outside threat, and they also have a very good presence on the inside.